Each part of the pre-planting stage builds on the previous one, building a foundation for a well-yielding crop. A critical part of the pre-planting stage is to split your herbicide application, half now pre-planting and half later during post-emergence. With center pivots, using a minimum or even no-till program reaps the same results while saving on energy, labor, and fuel. You may choose to irrigate during the pre-plant stage. Irrigation is commonly used at this time to put moisture in the soil and activate herbicides.
In a pivot rise situation, there's increased disease pressure. Up front, your variety or hybrid selection really is very important. You need to find a hybrid that has a good disease package, a good resistance to blast in particular. If you're set up to fertigrate, which we recommend, then you'll also be set up to run quadras through your pivot so you can avoid an application cost and actually get really good coverage when it goes through the pivot. So we got, you know, some healthy rice, dominant flag leaf here, and a good long grain head.
In the germination stage, make sure there's sufficient moisture around the seed and irrigate if conditions warrant. Too little moisture at this stage can affect emergence and plant population. During the early season, light, frequent applications are recommended. If you have a sandy soil, you can avoid wind erosion by running the pivot during this stage. For heavier soils, monitor the soil for cracking, an indication that this could lead to the roots breaking. Valley Precision Irrigation Equipment makes it easy to apply water evenly and precisely. In a flood field, all the herbicide would have to be put down in the pre-plant phase. With center pivot irrigation, however, in the two-leaf stage, now is the time to apply the second half, extending the effectiveness of the herbicide. Then use the pivot to activate the herbicide, saving both water and fuel. In traditional flood fields, it takes lots of work to pull in the levees and lots of water when the grower needs to flush the field.
This is a one-man show. There's no levees, there's no gates, there's no nobody has to worry about walking levees and checking levees. It's a matter of coming out here and we could program the pivot itself to start up every 2 days if we chose to.
With your pivot, simply keep the soil surface moist to minimize cracking or erosion to encourage plant development and early tillering. In the tillering stage, the plant begins to take up nutrients quickly. It's important not to short the plant on water. In this growth stage, nitrogen fertilizer can be spoon-fed through the pivot to support growth of your rice plants. Be vigilant. Start scouting the fields for disease and insects. A center pivot irrigated crop is more susceptible to blast or brown spot. If you identify it, apply a fungicide immediately to avoid disease spread. In the joint movement stage, panicle initiation is imminent, the moment when the plants begin to produce the rice grains. You'll need to apply more water during this stage and keep scouting for disease and insects.
We're going to make a trip with 3 to 4 tenths of water each time we go across this field, and we do that typically about every 2 days, depending on whether or not we get a rain. And as the crop needs the nitrogen, we've been spoon feeding it through the pivot by fertigating. So that's saved us money. It's putting the nitrogen right out there where we want it. And we don't have the aerial application.
As the panicles begin to produce rice grains, be sure to check your fertilizer application. Nitrogen application should be finishing up at this time. If the crop doesn't get enough, you could see fewer grains per panicle, and that will affect your yield. At grain fill, seed development is complete. During this stage, continue to provide adequate water to the crop. Continue to scout for disease and insects, applying fungicide and insecticide if needed. If water application is stopped too early, it can negatively affect milling quality.